There are two more software process models that I want to cover, so bear with me. The first one is the Relational Unified Software Process, or RUP, which is a very popular one based on UML. RUP works in an iterative way, which means that it performs different iterations, and at each iteration, it performs four phases. So what I'm showing you here is a high-level view of the process, and I don't want you to focus on all the different details, because we will discuss these details later on in a lesson that is actually dedicated to RUP. What I want to give you now is just the gist of how this works. So in each one of these four phases, which I'm going to describe in a second, we perform standard software engineering activities, the ones that we just discussed, and we do them to different extent based on the phase in which we are. In particular, in the inception phase, the work is mostly to scope the system. So basically figuring out what is the scope of the work, what is the scope of the project, what is the domain, so that we can be able to perform initial cost and budget estimates. The elaboration phase is the phase in which we focus on the domain analysis and define the basic architecture for the system. So this is a phase in which analysis and design are particularly relevant. Then there is the construction phase, which is where the bulk of the development actually occurs. And as you can see here, is where most of the implementation happens. And finally, the transition phase is the phase in which the system goes from development into production so that it becomes available to users. And of course, this is the phase in which the other activities in software development become less relevant and deployment becomes the main one.